We're back. Please use your mic.
Wonderful, thank you. You said that we can travel in a parallel universe. Well, how do you know when that happens? How do you distinguish that between, is there a difference between a dream and a when you travel to a parallel universe?
It depends how organized it is. Traveling to a parallel universe means that you go somewhere else where other things apply and so forth. It's an organized life. It doesn't mean that you will be able to bring back all the information to know exactly where you have been. It takes a lot of experience and a lot of knowledge of where you are heading. So it's not easy to clear it up. But it's a different society altogether, or it can be a different planet altogether. There are strange elements then that, but you don't remember. Then usually what happens when you return back, the only thing that is important is the emotions.
How you felt, you said. Yeah.
That you felt. Everything else, you have to somehow restructure them according to what you know here. Okay? So first you translate to the elements that you recognize as important elements, and then you have to interpret them somehow. So it's not possible from this particular point to know exactly where you will go, but there are parallel universes and you can go there. You can go there easily.
Would you say if you have a higher consciousness, you can interpret them in a more accurate way?
Yeah, because you know more. You know more, and therefore you can see more elements from the ones you know, and they differentiate from what you live here. I'll give you an example. Years ago, while I was dreaming, I ended up into a very extended hall where there was some kind of seminar happening, intergalactic movement. So the people who were participating, they were beings from various planets. They didn't look like humans. A lot of us look like humans, but there were all kinds of other anthropoids. Very tall, some giants. There were some people that were they look animal-like and so forth. So you know, that I brought back myself. But it could be. It doesn't mean that I remember exactly. Maybe from my knowledge, I was able to realize what it was all about and shaping the participants in ways that I knew already that they may look like. In other words, I cannot claim that I know exactly where it was. The final interpretation was some kind of seminar relating to intergalactic movement. So we're taking instructions.
So when you're traveling in a parallel universe, is it your soul that travels or your
of course your soul is traveling. And you're using your astral.
Yeah. How do you know to come back to the same
spot? Well, it comes back automatically. When you finish, you come back automatically. All it takes is somebody to wake you up and you came back.
That's what happened to me now.
Could be. All it takes is just to wake up.
Yeah.
Your body like people are theorizing about cords connected between your astral body and your physical body, nonsense. There is no space. You just come back automatically where you have been.
So how do you explain, do you believe people can be hypnotized? Yes? You believe in hypnosis? People can be hypnotized?
To tell you the truth, I paid a lot of money to hypnotize me.
I would love to be hypnotized.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Waste of money.
Is it?
Yes.
Why?
Nobody can hypnotize you unless you want to get hypnotized. That's why it was a waste of money. The only thing I confirmed is that I paid $250 for an hour and a half experience. I felt extremely heavy, but I was controlling myself from the beginning to the end.
Are you in a meditative state when you're hypnotized?
Oh, yeah.
How do you explain, it's been documented in a book that I read about people having been hypnotized by a special hypnotist, that they've gone back in other lives, and they've described in details the lives they have lived in other times.
Yeah, I mean, these people, they actually, apparently they permitted themselves to get hypnotized. They followed the instructions and they went to another life, peak experience. And that's all you can go. I mean, you don't go there to sleep. They will tell you, how did you die? Do you have any kids? I have kids, yeah. Who they are? These are big experiences.
But people have described in detail other type of lives that could only have been described at that time, not in today's society. Also, they've spoken in foreign languages.
Okay. Speaking another language has been documented many times. It's known as xenoglossy. And basically implies that you change your consciousness to the level of language. You understand? Because the language is also a communication tool which is based on knowledge. So they accepted the instructions and they used them.
But in consciousness, you don't know that language.
You don't know in your current consciousness. But when you go there, you are in an altered state of consciousness.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So you're changing. You're becoming another person in a way.
It is possible you agree that you can tap into your other previous lives if you have been reincarnated several times?
What is the question?
Do you believe that one can go to the past, other layers of other lives that we've been...
Yeah, you can go past lives or even future lives.
Through hypnosis?
Through hypnosis, yeah. As long as you know what you are doing and the person who is guiding you knows as well. But it all depends on your free will, you accept it or not. In my case, I was there as an observant. I never got hypnotized. I asked him, was I hypnotized? He said yes. My mind was very sharp throughout, but a bit heavy. That's like a very deep meditative state.
Well, what else? How else different could it have been? What did you expect?
You could go there to the point that you accepted changes of consciousness so drastically that you lost your identity. I didn't lose anything. I was feeling just heavy, but I was observing him. The only thing I confirm is, in other words, that I was in a meditative, very heavy meditative state. I never lost consciousness, never. And I was, I can confirm that really it's a matter of us to accept it or not. Which incidentally I have read it in advance. But now I confirmed it.
Yes. Okay. You say that we should give when receiving, we should give and take back only what is necessary.
Yeah. This is the goal.
What is it that is necessary?
Well, it's up to you. For some people, necessary will be to have an apartment. For me, this is necessary. I don't want more. I have more, but it's for my wife and child, not for me. I'm a visitor there. For me, this is what I consider necessary. I don't want just a cave and live on the extreme basics. I'm spoiled. This is necessary for me. It's a big office, actually, with a bedroom. So it's personal. It is necessary. It doesn't mean that I cannot live with less, but this is necessary. It makes me feel comfortable. Lock my door and sleep quietly.
So taking back is really, it's an individual comfort level.
Sorry?
Taking back what is necessary is depending on each individual's comfort level.
It's subjective. For some people, necessary is to have a palace with 450 rooms. For me, necessary is to have an office in the bedroom. The bedroom actually is not necessary. I mean, you notice how tough. When my wife comes and visits me, she hates that bed.
Too busy. It's very busy.
Me?
The bedroom.
It's very busy? What does that mean?
The walls are busy.
Yeah, it's loaded.
Loaded.
Yeah. And all of them have history. And all of them are personal items. Looks like my altar. My altar is extremely loaded, very heavy. But most of them are works of art and books. They're not as important. Some of them are important. Some of them I respect and I admire. Some of them I am proud I have them. Mostly personal memories. We are falling into a discussion of subjectivity.
Yeah. I have a question about, you say that, my question is, how do we, everything starts from the thinking and then we go to the emotion. So how do we change the way of thinking in order to change the emotions? Thus, and the question also is, do we make mistakes based on emotional thinking, emotional decisions? And how do we control the emotional decisions to avoid mistakes? No.
When you seek control, you are actually you are implying that you want to reduce your fear, your uncertainty. That's what control means. Okay? Now, the only way to control your uncertainty is by knowledge. You have to reach to the point of what you are thinking is something that you know it's true. And you can only know that something is true if you have lived it by personal experience. So I'm giving you the goals and I'm describing the final. I am giving you descriptions of the final picture, but it's a very composite picture and very dense picture. I give you the full picture though, diagrammatically. That's what my models do. But this is details. And you notice there was just a leaf, and here we have seven leaves. And all of them connect in such a way that answers hundreds of questions. Whereas over there, you can even ask the questions. But between this and this, there are hundreds of presentations.
Based on the statement you made that likes attract likes, bad attracts bad. When you have two individuals that have attracted to each other, one behaves in a negative or bad way, and the other, who's attracted to that individual, follows along and also follows along with the bad behavior or the negative behavior because they're attracted to that individual. Does that also make that person bad?
Yeah.
And then you also said, and bad things happen to people who do bad.
Yeah.
You said that. So why does... See, if you know what you're about to do is wrong,
well,
but
you
do it anyway, because you're with an individual who is behaving wrong.
Well, you were attracted to him because you were behaving wrong, because in reality, you have elements of being bad. You have
so
to understand
this is
that.
The truth. This is the actual, yeah.
Yeah. So you were attracted. It doesn't mean that you are as bad as him. But you are willing to play.
So in a weird way, maybe even subconsciously, you also have those elements.
You do. You do.
Without realizing it.
Mm-hmm. You do. See, if you reach to the point of knowing what you are doing, then you don't choose that direction. You mm-hmm. belong somewhere else.
You turn. You turn away.
You have turned already.
Yeah. That's interesting.
Yeah, it is. You have to transform to go from bad to good. Transformation implies permanent change. It's energetic realignment. Then you feel differently, you attract differently, you are thinking differently, your emotions are different, you are another person. You are becoming another person, although physically it's the same person.